Alright everyone, welcome back to 007 Nightfire on the GameCube with me, Paul's Classic Gamer, part of my 007 playlist. Not sure when this will be uploaded or when Agent on the Fire will be uploaded at this point. I haven't really decided. Haven't even got edited any, put anything through editing yet. Next up is probably one of the most infuriating missions. Chain Reaction, where you literally have snipers everywhere. Why is my thing not working? Oh, don't flash, please. Why is my thing not working? I didn't take it out, did I? No. Bear with me a minute, guys. My controller has decided it doesn't want to work. Right. Now it works.
We've decrypted the Nightfire files you secured last night, 007. They contain rather troubling data concerning a shutdown nuclear power plant not far from Tokyo. Phoenix Corporation has been contracted to cleanse the plant of radioactive material. We now suspect that massive amounts of construction have been secretly carried out inside the towers. Your mission is to infiltrate the plant and find out what Drake is hiding. As always, 007, best of luck.
Of course, dismantling a nuclear reactor is an incredibly delicate operation.
And dangerous as well, yes?
That is why we've invested in robot technology, like those forklifts. Insanely expensive. But keeping our people safe is important. And when our work is done, the beaches here will be clean enough for our children to swim and their grandfathers to fish.
Thank you, Mr. Drake. I appreciate the exclusive interview.
And so do I. Interview is over, Mr. Rook.
All snipers back in position.
Oh, so last time we saw him was we blew him up the sky in the first level, if you remember. You don't really come to face him in this level. It's more hearing him. Oh my god, it's got a laser sight on it now. I need to start taking these guys out. Can you actually get up there? I would have thought you could, but I want to do a bit of exploration on this.
I see him. Spotted.
one more guy. He's in the big barn. I don't think I can get him. Are there any in this area? Any bomb moves that I can do? If I take this as nice, if I don't rush at this, I should be able to get what I want to get, which is of course bomb moves. The move when you start, turn around, laser the pointing pins, jumping for a fighting position, a bomb move. Once you're on the ground, the area that you were looking for, were looking down at the beginning, you need to be able to get out of the way of the bunker in the middle, facing it. Not quite sure what it's talking about, but... I know it's not ideal, but I don't really have a choice. Serious.
Take cover.
I see you. Back down.
That is bullshit, because that was 100% a shot.
Behind the shipping crates.
Why is that not really? Are you kidding? That is so bullshit. I'm shooting at the fucking things and it won't blow up.
I see him.
Of course you don't fucking do it. Of course you don't. Even though I tell you to fucking get up there and crouch so you can land on it, you don't want to do it. Other fucking bomb moves are. Once you're out in the open ground, the area where you were looking down in the beginning, get the grapple out your grapple and allow all the way around the right of the bunker in the middle. Facing it from one angle, there's a grapple and broken metal stairs. It's too high. Ah, that's what it's saying to do. You need to get on this crane, this forklift that is running around. So if I can get behind this thing. Why is that, of all things, a bomb move? In the last room, flip the lever in the control room to activate the large T-beam. It'll start moving back and forth. Step outside the control room and grab onto the nearest hook. Wait until the beam is under you. Landing on it will give you a bomb move. No idea what that is talking about. Absolutely not got a clue. Oh, so you're too low. Even jumping a little bit, you're still too low. Fucking knock my health down. That is what you did earlier. I feel I will finish this today. In terms of James Bond games after that, I think we might be... We'll be done with we've only got one more console one to do, and that's Only Everything and Nothing. And then afterwards, it'll be PC. But I'm going to break the mold a little bit and do a PC after I've done this. Probably will do this version on PC. I played the PC version not as openly as familiar with it as I am with this game. I remember this game really vividly. But the reason why I don't not remember the PC version, but there's no driving in the PC version, which I think is a big, big letdown. It's such a shame. Such an awful shame that that is actually the case. Accept bullshit shots. Fucking missed. How did that not hit him? How is that not registering as a hit? Doing this area. In the last room, flip the lever in the control room to activate the large TV. Oh, it means that thing in the middle there? It must mean that, surely. Because I've never done this before, so that has to be what it means. Where's the fucking control room? No, that isn't the fucking... That isn't the tea. No, I know what it means. It means the crane. It's not in here. The fact that I thought that was that being there was probably the TV. Means I don't need to fucking fight. Go down there.
Deploy the red team and take him down.
Take cover! He's on the stairs. I see him. He's behind the shooting crates. I've lost him.
Maybe I can take out one person before anything else happens.
Behind the shooting crates.
Yeah. Okay. I can't fucking see him. That's who's shooting at me. It's the guy fucking behind. That's who's spotting me.
Intruder spotted.
Fuck you.
Two of them in there, but I can't quite get a shot from where I am.
Intruder spotted. He's on the stairs. Down.
one more that side. This is actually fucking hard on this delivery. Again.
I see him.
Now I know exactly where you are. Come on! Definitely I'll shoot him in there.
Intruder spotted.
Come on! James.
I see him.
Do you know what? I've shot at that glass before and it hasn't done any damage to him. So I will obviously be cutting out failures and stuff in this video, but this is just going to be the Phoenix Fire video. Well, not Phoenix Fire video, sorry. The Tactical Sniper, I think this is called. So this LP is turning to be more each mission is its own video, which I think the later missions need to be, especially if I'm going to be redoing stuff if I don't always do it. There is that as well, of course. So, what does it mean to do when I do that? In the last room, flip the lever in the control room to activate the large T beam. I will start moving back and forth, step outside the control room, and grapple to the nearest hook until the beam is under you. Landing on it will get you a bomb move. Right, so it's not this crane here. It's the one in the very last room.
He's gone inside.
Come on. There's got to be a better way of doing that.
He's gone inside.
Bye bye guys. Enjoy shooting after me.
Kiko, where have you been?
Trying to catch up with you. Better miss me. Come on. You must be exhausted, James. What would you say to a little nap?
And we got the gold medal for this mission, which is absolutely what I wanted to get. So let's see, 3 out of 2 bomb moves, which certainly helped. 47 out of 45 guards dispatched, that really did help. Subdued, none. Surrendered, none. Stealth rating, 0. So obviously there isn't a target for that. It isn't a stealth mission. Accuracy, 58%. That's not bad. 100%, 95% health remaining. That's good. 17 minutes out of 20. That's also good because it's under the time we needed. Bond bonuses, none because there aren't any yet. Subtotal, 258,000. Difficulty bonus, 258,000. And total, 516,000. Well, that is the end of that. Upgraded dart gun. Wonder what that actually entails. All right then, guys, that's going to be the end of that. Thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.